Hey everybody, welcome to Not Just Another Market Update with Keith and Brian. My name is Brian Melville with REMAX of Santa Clarita.
Keith Renno, Wintrust Mortgage.
Yeah, we're going to take a deep dive into all things mortgage and real estate related right here in the Santa Clarita Valley. Let's go. So welcome, thanks for watching. You know, we just wanted to share with you guys some of the things happening right here in the real estate and mortgage industry. These things are changing quickly all the time, and our goal, frankly, is to be educators. Let's face it, statistics aren't really that sexy and fun, but they definitely matter. We're keeping it really professional. We've got notes for you guys today, just because there's been some happenings going on and some statistics that we feel are worth sharing, right?
Absolutely, all about making educated choices.
Let's start with the headline.
Yeah.
Rates dropped.
The Fed decided not to increase rates. We're back to where rates were February of 2018, so a lot of opportunity right now.
What is that rate today then?
About 4.25. I think things will pick up rapidly from here.
You know what I normally have done in the past, those of you who have watched my blogs are familiar with my little format of kind of giving you a quick snapshot of what is going on in the market. But today I pulled the numbers. 572 active properties, which is the same number basically we had January 25th when I pulled these last. So literally no change. Now that may or may not sound like a big number, but I would assure you that it's not a very high number. You know, that means there's still probably more home buyers out there depending on the price range looking for homes than are currently available. Now the pending and backup sales, look at this, Keith, this is crazy. 433 homes are currently under contract. Now, but that's 38% more homes under contract than in January. Now, one other statistic that I love is the homes that have sold in the last 30 days, right? I'm just always looking at a rolling 30-day cycle. 258 homes have closed in the last 30 days. That number is also up 34% from January. So yeah, we went to an economic outlook meeting where we kind of got the whole state of affairs of everything in Santa Clarita, and the message overwhelmingly was kind of more of the same, definitely not like a big decrease and the sky is falling. At least that's what I got from it.
If anything, a lot of positivity. We're not gonna see as much growth, but growth.
Now here is the one that's really, really important for those of you watching who might be considering a home sale. Mm-hmm. 46% of those properties that had sold in the last 30 days had sold for less than the list price. Mm-hmm. Keith mentioned something when we were off camera before we started that this probably has a lot to do with the sort of wintertime blues and the seasonal slowdown. Obviously, it's the first day of spring.
Kinda.
Well, it looks great. We had hail today. But the spring selling season is in effect right now. So mm-hmm. as we go March, April, May, and even parts of June, those are the best months. Just a couple of quick stats. The overall absorption rate, which means how many months of inventory is available here in Santa Clarita, we're at 1.97, so just about 2 months supply, which overall would still read like a seller's market. But here's what's interesting. Once you get to 800,000, 600,000 to 800,000, we get about 2.5 months supply, starting to slow down. And when you get to 800 to 999, we got 4 months supply, and anything over a million, we're now at 6.23 months supply. When you're looking at 4 to 6 months of inventory, these are the homes where there's going to be the greatest opportunity to negotiate a price off the list price. Why don't we just kind of tie this together here, I think, with interest rates, because you talk about this stuff, and I think for me, I even get mind blown, because I'm like, he pulls up a graph, and I just, all of a sudden you hear, like, have you ever heard, like, smoldering wires? It goes, and like, my head pops, because I'm just like, oh shit, here we go. Yeah, how does this all tie together with what you know?
Yeah, so historically, anytime we've seen an increase in rate, and that's what we saw throughout 2018, we went from the low fours all the way up to about 5% throughout the year. And anytime we have an increase in rate, we'll typically see a slowdown in home prices, and we'll generally see that slowdown for anywhere from a 9 to a 12 month period thereafter that rate increase. Now we've seen interest rates come back down with the lack of confidence going on in the stock market that has helped our interest rate. The Fed has taken a dovish approach where they're not increasing the Fed funds rate. So those things combined, we've now seen rates lower back down to that low 4% range. And I think coming out of the winter season, getting into the springtime, we had a month of February out here in Santa Clarita where it did not get over 70 degrees. That hasn't happened in years and years. So
been here a long time. Yeah,
I think that caused some slowness to start the year. But I think with the rates coming down and what we're seeing here as far as how the market's going, I think we'll see things quickly pick up and that momentum will gain quickly.
Look, here's the message. Get off the fence. I get it. When rates go up and prices are as high as they are, you start to feel like, oh, forget it. Now, I will say this. I do believe there's some people that love to use the word recession. And I think it's like almost a self-fulfilling prophecy because they'd love to say, I'm not going to do it. There's a recession coming. Because what they want to do is have a great story to share with their friends about, oh boy, I dodged that bullet. Boy, that, remember 2019 when I didn't buy a house because I was worried about the recession?
Yep.
Nailed it. Yep. Called it.
really, we're talking about a recession, we're really talking about the stock market. And throughout history, when we've had recessions, rarely has that affected real estate. Oftentimes, when we have a recession, real estate is actually going up because investors are taking their money and they're parking them in a relatively safe, secure investment, which is generally real estate. When we think of recession, or most of us, you probably watching this video, think of recession, we think of 2008, where the whole economy was in recession, home prices were dropping. That's how we relate to recession, but that's not historic.
It's not a great depression, so you're not going to be in a bread line anytime soon.
There's
you're going to be buying houses. Keith had some great information here, and it talks a little bit about some of the statistics, household incomes and things like that in Santa Clarita. Why don't we share some of that? Because I found that to be very interesting.
So out here in Santa Clarita, over 40% of our households make at least $125,000. Now, when we compare that to, say, the San Fernando Valley, where 26% of those households make that $125,000 plus mark, we have such a healthy, strong residency out here in Santa Clarita, where we can really warrant our average home price of around $600,000. And keep in mind, I said at least $125,000. So many of those households are making more, and they can comfortably afford that $600,000 to $800,000.
You're saying $600,000 is something someone at $125,000 combined household income can easily afford. I mean, we're at about 1.5, 1.6 months supply. So this, see, it all ties together. This is why we try to take a deep dive and have these numbers mean something to you, because everybody's talking and they're not doing a lot of speaking about what's the impact, like what's in it for me? What does that mean to you? Home mortgages are complicated. Real estate can be complicated. You got to lean on people like us here that are able to help you decipher this information. I mean, the mere fact that 41.5% of the household incomes in Santa Clarita make $125,000 more is crazy, and only 26 in San Fernando Valley. I mean, Santa Clarita is winning. This is a wonderful place to live. The economy is strong, and all things considered, I think there's still a lot of growth opportunity. I mean, we haven't even got into the fact that there's about 30,000 more new homes coming. Let's get real. We're becoming a technology hub. The greater Los Angeles area is becoming like the third largest hub for technology. These companies are wanting to come out here, and we have land available. I think what's happening is this unique opportunity right now where there's a perfect storm of need and availability of land, and these projects are underway. In fact, I think there was another stat that there was about even 900 new apartment units coming out here, which, you know, it doesn't sound like a lot, but it actually is really a lot, and they hadn't built any apartment housing out here since about 2013. So what do we want to finish with, Keith? I mean, is there any like sort of like last things that we want to share with everybody? I mean, hope and optimism are always good, and we don't want to ever provide that just as a mechanism to get you to do something. I actually still think, I believe in my heart of hearts, that this is still a great time to do something, and you should feel encouraged by everything that we're sharing with you. So where can they reach you? And I'll put all this up on the screen as well, but share the info, man.
Yeah, please call me direct. My cell phone, 818-521-8515. My website with all my contact information, keithreno.com.
And, you know, I'm Brian Melville with the Melville team at RE/MAX. You can reach me at 661-702-4711. Brian at the Melville team. And hey, look, you know, we appreciate you guys taking a listen to our sort of first real vlog with a title now. I feel like we're kind of official, at least, you know?
I feel it.
Not just another market update.
Hopefully you do too.
So, you know, we're going to try to keep it this way, you know, keep a flow, a state of the market, and then maybe give you some other Santa Clarita factoids. So, you know, as always, I say it, the opportunities are everywhere if you know where to look, and nowadays, more than ever, the right agent, the right team, right real estate and lender team matters. So let us know what we can do to serve you. We hope this message resonates with you. That's all we're trying to do, is connect on a higher level. And thanks for watching, you guys.
Thank you. Take care.